Rockers, made for the doers, the movers, shakers, not connoisseurs.
I want to ask about dancing. I feel like you're making music that is really easy to dance to, and then lyrics are also kind of focusing on, you know, bigger themes or like maybe heavier ones. Do you feel like dance music is kind of like a sneaky way to like get lyrics across?
We are sort of an intellectual band in the sense that we're text-based and we ask a lot of questions, and you know, there are a lot of puns, and we are very word-based, which can be exhausting to have a nonstop text. You know, I think we can hopefully get away with that if we engage the body simultaneously. And ultimately, I think of our lyrics as percussive as well. You know, in songs like Throne or Doers, I'm thinking of my mouth as a drum. You know, the eighth notes and the 16th notes are playing against what Ty and everyone else is doing. Lyrics, of course, we choose for their meaning, but first and foremost, I think we choose them because they sound musical.
Although this hasn't quite come up as much in our recordings yet, we do like to jam on stage. We've been like working on that more. We take references from the Grateful Dead from that, of how they have like blocks in a row, you know, and how they choose to get theirs different every time of like in the song set. We make jokes, but like we definitely like either like we're punk jam adjacent or jam punk adjacent. Also, this band, whether it was Bodega or Bodega Bay, has always had a stand-up drummer and was kind of conceived around drumming like that. I feel like the kick is just louder in the mixes and just like in stage presence than most other bands. So there's already kind of like a theatrical, like there's like a built-in like performance aspect of someone like drumming, and the live performance, something like Choose Your Own Adventure. You know, where you kind of like follow one person on stage and you can like see them like in their journey through the music one time, and then you switch and it's like a completely different performance and like, you know, I guess energy happening.
You got the inspiration for recording Broken Equipment from a book club. Can you tell me a little bit more about this book club?
2019 actually really is when it started. Me and our drummer Ty started this book club with a couple of friends of ours. This guy Adam, who is now our new bass player, he teaches philosophy for a living, but I think he was kind of bored with the academic world. I mean, he likes his job, but I think philosophy was becoming a little too routine for him. He wanted to experience philosophy like how you do when it's new. So yeah. I remember saying with Ty, we had this sort of idea that, oh, it's too bad our band can't be like this book club, in the sense that, you know, we could meet up once a week and, you know, we're like a little gang. You know, it was just a big bonding kind of thing. A lot of what we read influenced the lyrics of the new record, but more so, I think, finding sort of bookish rock and rollers to collaborate with was, you know, huge for us. It's fun.
Was there a particular book that was like a standout in terms of like inspiration and sparking discussion?
The big one would be Being in Time, Heidegger. That led to a lot of the sort of concepts on the record. The first one we read, which is by far the most controversial, was Nietzsche's Beyond Good and Evil. He's more literary than philosophical in the way he's witty and often says ironic things that he doesn't really mean. I mean, he says absolutely outrageous, shocking things. He's a little bit like the Kanye West of his time or something like that. He's fun to read because he keeps you on your toes.
For all millennia, you'll always be stuck in the woods.
How are you gonna manage that?